We previously talked about the unique administration of the rabies vaccine, in that it's often given after somebody has a potential exposure. But for today's video, we want to expand on that information and talk about the complete rabies post-exposure prophylaxis schedule, or PEP schedule. So during this schedule, there are two main treatments that are used. One is that vaccine, and the second is human rabies immune globulin. Now, these are both given on day zero, so someone will receive their first vaccine dose, as well as the dose of human rabies immune globulin. But that dose is going to be dependent on the weight of an individual versus how much they're actually given, and it's often given into their upper thigh. And that gives the body a head start for your immune system to begin fighting off the rabies infection, as it's directly providing you those antibodies before your immune system has a chance to begin making its own antibodies from the vaccine. But it's only given on day zero to individuals who have just started this series. So if previously you've had a rabies exposure, you're not going to receive this human rabies immune globulin, you're just going to receive that vaccine booster. Then on day three, someone will receive their second dose of vaccine. On day seven, they'll receive their third dose of vaccine. And then finally, 2 weeks later, they'll receive their fourth and final dose of vaccine. However, if somebody is immunocompromised, they will receive a fifth dose of the rabies vaccine about a month after that initial dose. And a fun fact about the rabies post-exposure prophylaxis schedule is that I actually had to go through this exact schedule about 8 years ago when I first started grad school due to a potential exposure with rabies. So to learn more about different health-related topics, make sure to stay connected to my channel as well as with Dane Garvin.